sanctify your heart from dead works to serve the living God. Look at that verse again, verse 14. It says, look at what the old covenant people had, the pardon they have. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that was within me, bless his holy name. Old covenant, who forgiveth all thine iniquities. Old covenant, who healeth all the diseases. Old covenant. He said, if that happened to the Old Testament people by the blood of goats and bulls, how much more if he pardoned them then, if he purified them then, people like Isaiah, your sin is taken away and you are purged. If that happened to them, how much more? If you say you cannot be righteous and pure, holy and godly, you kind of belittle the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of animals made them pure at that time in the old covenant. And today, that same blood will purge you, purify you, sanctify you, make you holy through and through. And you will be higher, holier, purer than the Old Testament people. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal spirit, all those Old Testament sacrifices offered by those priests of the old covenant, they were faulty. They themselves were sinful. And they didn't offer those sacrifices by the eternal spirit. It's telling you how high the sacrifice of Jesus is, how effective the blood of Jesus Christ is. He offered himself through the eternal spirit. And then it says, without spot. And he offered himself to God. Now he'll purge your conscience and purge your spirit and purge your heart from dead works, and you'll be able to serve the living God. 1 John 1:7. 1 John 1, reading from verse 7, the blood of Jesus, the benefits we have through that blood, the purifying we have through that blood, the holiness we have through that blood, and the renewed cleansing of the heart by that blood. 1 John 1:8. But if we walk in the light, why wouldn't we? After you are pardoned, why wouldn't you walk in the light after you are reconciled unto God? Why wouldn't you? If you're walking with God and walking with the Lord, because two cannot walk together except we be agreed. And he is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. We have understanding, unity one with another. The division is gone. The wall of partition is broken down. The hatred between the Jews and the Gentiles, all that is gone. And between Gentile and Gentile, all those conflicts are gone. We now have fellowship, reconciliation, relationship, love, one with another. And then it says, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin, purges us from all sin, purifies us from all sin, sets us free from all sin. It tells us in Hebrews chapter 10, I'm reading here from verse 19. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 19. It says, having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Having now boldness to enter. You are no more doubting. You are no more vacillating. You are no more going up and down in your mind. You are no more questioning in your mind. Can I be holy? Can I be pure? Can I be sanctified? Can I live a life that is transparently holy? He said, look at what Jesus has done. Look at the blood he has shed. And look at the effect of that blood. and look at the efficacy of the blood of Jesus Christ. Now you should have the assurance to enter into the very presence of the Lord and be as holy as Calvary can make you, as holy as the blood of Jesus Christ can make you, as righteous and godly, as purified as the blood of the Lamb can make you, and even enter into the holiest sanctuary, and the holiest experience, and the holiest state of mind by the blood of the Lamb. It says, having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Is there any inward sin you have been thinking? That's my peculiar fault. I cannot overcome that. Is there anything that you have been excusing and allowing in your heart? That's my peculiarity. I can overcome others. I can be victorious on others. But this is peculiar. You have not applied the blood of Jesus to that peculiar situation of yours. You can come this morning to the holiest, and then the Lord can so purge you, and you'll be purer than you have ever experienced in your life, because the blood has been shed, and it's not going to shed the blood again. All that he needs to do to sanctify you and to make you holy and to purify your life, he's done everything. And now we have boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way which he has consecrated for us through the veil, that is to say, his flesh. And now he is the high priest of our profession. In chapter 13, I'm reading just Hebrews chapter 13. I'm reading from verses 12 and 13. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 12. Wherefore, Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood. Join those two things together. Sanctification is own blood. Sanctification by his own blood. When you come to the full realization of what Calvary has provided, you will not stop at salvation. Because Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people, purify the people, make the people transparently holy with his own blood, he suffered outside the gate, without the gate. Let us go forth, therefore, unto him without the camp, outside the camp, bearing his reproach. The people who do not know the power in the blood of the Lamb might reproach you, might ridicule you, might make fun of you. It says, bear that and count the glory that shall come greater than all the reproaches of the day, and count the wonder of that sanctification and the wonder of the purity of heart and purity of life higher and greater than whatever reproaches people may level against you. Verse 20, it says, now the God of peace, that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant. There's no other covenant after the covenant of the blood of Jesus. Is a new covenant, is the last covenant, is the everlasting covenant. Through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work, to do his will, working in you that which is well pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. And everybody said, amen. Amen. See, you can come and be cleansed in the blood. You can come and be washed in the blood. Purification will come. And then you'll be able to rejoice in the Lord, saying, I am saved. Have peace with God. I am saved. I have pardon. I am sanctified. I have purity. I am made holy. I have that power over sin. That's what it takes. And that's what the blood will do. Without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. And we get that holiness, that purity of heart, that sanctification through the blood that Jesus shed for us on the cross of Calvary. And now we can come to the throne of grace to receive and receive at his hand. In Revelation chapter 7, you'll discover that multitudes receive this experience through the blood of the Lamb. Multitudes are saved, they are pardoned, they are peace, they are sanctified, they are purity, they are power over sin through the blood of the Lamb. If multitudes have got it, if multitudes will get it, you should be one of them. Revelation chapter 7 verse 9. After this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands, and cried with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our God, which sitteth upon the throne, and unto the Lamb. And all the angels stood round about the throne, and about the elders, and the four beasts, and fell, the four living creatures, and they fell before the throne on their faces, and worshipped God, saying, amen, blessing, and glory, and wisdom, and thanksgiving, and honor, and power, and might be unto our God forever and ever. Amen. And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, what are these which are rich in white robes? Whence came they? And I said unto him, sir, thou knowest. And he said to me, these are they. Listen to this. These are they which came out of great trial, great temptation, great trouble, great tribulation. It's not the great tribulation, great tribulation, great trials, great difficulties, great persecution. And they have washed their robes and made them white. How? I said, how? Tell me out loud. In the blood of the Lamb. For you to be holy enough to get to heaven is the blood of the Lamb. Pure enough to get to heaven is the blood of the Lamb. The one you try by yourself, I'll not do this, I'll not do that, that's not sufficient. That one will have blemish. That one will have spot. That one will have failure. But when you come to the throne of grace and you say, I need genuine salvation, free, that makes me victorious. I need real sanctification, real cleansing, purifying, that gives me the holiness that God himself will recognize and approve of. That's going to take the blood of the Lamb. These are they which have come out of great tribulation, and they have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, look at that word, therefore, because they are washed. Therefore, because they are cleansed. Therefore, because they are purified. Therefore, and because they are sanctified, made holy, therefore, are they before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more, neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb, which is in the midst of the throne, shall feed them, and shall lead them unto living water, living fountains of waters. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. It's the blood of the Lamb that does that. And so cleanses you, and so purges you, and so purifies you, and makes you ready ready for heaven. Ephesians chapter 5. I'm reading from verse 25. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25. Husbands, love your wives, you will if you are born again. Husbands, love your wives. That's the commandment of the Lord. And if you are born again, you'll fulfill you. You'll obey that. Even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. You understand? Christ loved the world. He gave himself for the salvation of the world, for the pardon, for the peace of the world. Salvation. But now the church is through that same love of Christ, the love that saved the world, the people coming out of the world, that love that made Christ die for us, he gave himself for us, that he might sanctify and cleanse the church with the washing of water by the word, that he might present the church to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish, that he does by his blood, the cleansing in his blood, the purifying through his blood, the purging through his blood. It says, he did that he might cleanse us, that he might sanctify us, that he might purify us and present us to himself, a glorious church, not having spot. That's talking about things that are not conducive or conforming to the glory of God, or wrinkle, the marks of the old nature, the marks of the old man, the characteristics of the old life, wrinkle, or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. Revelation chapter 19. In Revelation chapter 19, reading from verse 7, let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him, honor to the Lord, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife has made herself ready. How? Look at verse 8. And to her was granted that she should be arrayed in fine linen, clean and white. For the fine linen is the righteousness of the saints. That's the righteousness, the godliness, the purity, the sanctification he grants to the saints. And to get to heaven, you need that. And it comes through the blood of Jesus Christ. Number one, peace and pardon. Number two, purity and power. Number three, protection and provision in his blood, or through his blood. It is that blood, the blood of the Lamb, the blood flowing from Calvary, the blood of Jesus Christ, the blood is shed for you. The same blood that grants peace and pardon. That same blood that grants purity and power over sin. That's the same blood